Having understood the contents of the spreadsheet, the next process is to design the table content. So, using this project as a case study, the standard diversity factor for lighting is 0.9. But we can observe the designer of this project did a little mistake, although there is always confusion about diversity factors among professionals. But on the norm, the standard diversity factor for lighting is 0.9, while for AC is 0.8, for outlet is 0.7, and 0.8 for motor devices, which mostly conveyance system entails. So for our lighting point here, we'll be having 0.9 as our standard, likewise 0.9, 0.9. And the fourth here is a 13/15 ampere socket. To make it easier, I can just say socket outlet. Socket. Sorry. Socket. So for our socket here, the standard is 0.7. 0.7. And 0.7. So having gotten that, the next is the standard for our split AC, which is 0.8, 0.8, 0.8, 0.8, 0.8, 0.8, enter. So, and for our cooker control unit is an outlet too. So it's 0.7. Likewise for our hot water heater, they are all 0.7. And for our spares too, 0.7. So having done that, we specify the number of points per circuit. So let's assume in our project we're having 10 circuits here. 10. Let's assume 10 or 2. For our socket, let's assume 5 or 2. And we have gamma 1 for AC. And for spare, the general assumption is 5 points. So we do have like 30% of our distribution board open in case of future growth. So having designed that, we now proceed to the load per phase, which is our major concern. On a norm, the calculation here is that we multiply the load per point by the diversity factor by the number of circuits. That's why from our formula here is F13 multiplied by G13 multiplied by H13. So we just write equals to the circuit we want to multiply, F13 multiplied by shift 8 G13 shift 8 again. You could see it has already highlighted, multiplied by H13. Enter. So that's why we have it here. So you repeat the same operation for all the phases in our board. And when you are done with this, the major concern is this section, which is the total load per phase. So it's just an addition of the red phase, this is an addition of the yellow phase, and this is an addition of the blue phase. Red. And this is an addition of the yellow, and this is an addition of the blue. So this is all what it entails. So for this, the formula is equals to sum. So just write equals to, let's take a case study, equals to SUM, SUM. Shift bracket and you specify where it's coming from, or you can use the mouse. So it's adding this, enter. So that's why we have it here. Okay. So you repeat the same operation for all the other faces. And finally, the major concern is the face balancing. You need to balance your distribution board. For example, in this project, you have 7,950 wattage here, 7.2 here, and 7.7 here. Although it's relatively close, but you can still do some modification or reduction. So for example, now let's bring 1.4 here. Just press Ctrl X and place it here, Ctrl V, and you bring 1.05 here, Ctrl X, Ctrl V. So you need to balance the circuit. There, another thing we can modify, let's bring 1.4 out here, Ctrl X, place it here, Ctrl V. So let's take this Ctrl X and bring it here, Ctrl V. So this is how we edit. You could observe we have 7.6, 7.6 and 7.7, which is more better than the former one. Although in Revit will automatically balance your circuits for you. But if you could observe, some of my borders have been deleted. So that's why I just come over here and design another border here. All better. So we've balanced our circuits. And having gotten the total load, this is just the total load for each faces in our distribution board. The next thing is to determine the total load for the distribution board, which is just an addition of the tray. So I'm having 7.6 or 7,600, 7,600 and 7,750. So you add. But here, the unit is in kilowatts, unlike here, which the unit is in watts. So that's why we have divided by 1,000 in our formula bar here. So divided by 1,000, giving me 22.95. Having gotten the total kilowatt, which is the major concern in every electrical project design, is enough for an electrical engineer. But to make it easier for other professionals, you need to convert it to load amperage. And to convert, we use P equals to root 3 IV power factor. So that's why I have scale root 3 times 415, which is my country voltage standard. Another thing that always confuses professionals is that some people might consider I'm only using single phase in my project. So we are not referring to the incomer, we are referring to the distribution board. So here is the standard formula.